Back again with wisdom and motivation from the Bible this year. If you need a resource to get into the Bible regularly, we definitely recommend the Bible Recap with Tara Lee Cobble, or why not both, the Daily Audio Bible with Brian Harden and his wonderful team. So we talked about Exodus in the last video. If you missed that one, be sure to go check it out. Today we're gonna stay in the book of Exodus, except the chapters we'll be working on are chapters 13 through 15. So at this point in the story, the Israelites have been set free. Pharaoh has let them go. They've been in slavery all this time, and during their time in slavery, they were praying, God, save us. He heard their cries. He went to set them free. It was hard. It wasn't easy. Pharaoh wasn't going to let them go. Finally broke Pharaoh, and he sent them free, and now they're finally free. But they're complaining a whole lot. Now, I do have to say, they are in a situation that's not the most ideal. It wasn't straight from freedom to paradise. They are in the wilderness. They were being chased by Pharaoh's soldiers, because turns out he changed his mind. He's like, wait a second, how am I going to run my empire without, you know, millions of slaves? So he's chasing them. They're in the desert. They're in the wilderness. Okay. They're not like at Bucky's on their way to their next stop. All right. So it's not ideal. So I get, as a human and them being human, I understand their complaints. But what they're complaining about in light of the miracles that are happening around them, the promises God's fulfilling, what's promised to them in the near future, the complaints do seem a little like, why are you complaining about that? Suck it up, buttercup, let's go. But again, we're all human. We've probably been in similar situations. I'm thinking of like hashtag first world problems kind of things. So they are complaining to Moses, though. And Moses is like, why do you keep coming to me with your requests? Go to God. Like, don't ask me, ask God. And I kind of think of like when my kids will ask me something because they know I might say yes, but Dad might say no. Or they go and ask Dad because he might say yes and I might say no. But everybody keeps taking their grumblings to Moses. And so I just want to find us in this story. And there's this catchy little phrase that goes, have you prayed about it more than you've complained about it? And I think that definitely applies here to the Israelites in this story. And so I wanted to know what that does in your life. What does that stir up in your heart? What is it that you've been complaining about? And have you been taking your complaints to the wrong person? And why don't you go to God? Is it because you know deep down maybe it's not worth complaining about? Is it you need to up your faith a little bit more? You're not sure if you take it to him that he's going to hear you, be there for you, or can fix it? Don't forget, God's almighty. He's all powerful. He can do these things. So definitely ask yourself, have you prayed about it more than you've complained about it? Take it to the right source. And then the next part too, if you are looking to make a big change in your life, right? Maybe you were a slave to something and now you've been praying to God to set you free. He set you free. The Bible is very honest. They don't sugarcoat this anywhere, that just because you've been saved, just because you've been freed from slavery, doesn't mean that life's going to be easy. It's not. But here's the thing. It was hard when you were enslaved to something. And there's going to be challenges on the outside of it. Guys, we're on the planet Earth. This is not our home forever, okay? If it was heaven here, then what's the point of going to heaven for eternity if we already got it, okay? So there's this thing that I've seen floating around a lot of social media about choose your heart. Choose your heart. It's hard to be overweight and out of shape and not happy when you look in the mirror. It's also hard to choose the healthy options, to get up and work out consistently. They're both hard. Choose your heart. So here, if I was with the Israelites and I was going to be the hype man, I'd be all like, guys, choose our heart. Slavery was hard. Sure, this is hard. But if I had to choose which heart I wanted, I'd rather be free. I want the free hard stuff, not the enslaved hard stuff. So definitely check in with yourself. If there's something you've been battling with and God's answering your call and maybe it's not going exactly as planned, just remember, both are hard. Which side of the fence do you want to be on that one? So definitely shift your focus. That's what I would encourage you to do. I think if the Israelites would have been more focused on all the miracles they just witnessed, like the Passover, right? That's insane. The Spirit came by and killed all these people's kids, but not theirs. They parted the Red Sea and walked through it. Well, God parted the Red Sea so they could walk through it. There's just constant miracle after miracle. And I mentioned this in a video prior. Some people are waiting on a sign. They're waiting on a miracle. But based on what we see in the Bible, I don't know that that's necessarily enough to solidify that you would do it. I wouldn't be like those people. So I do think if their perspective was looking at everything God had done for them instead of their needs that they would have liked to have fulfilled in that moment, that that could have given them the boost in the faith that they needed. So since I wasn't there and I may not have been as, you know, hype man as I am right now, let me be your hype man. Maybe that's why you're listening to this video today. Instead of focusing on all the things that aren't going right in your life today, this week, this season, look back on where God has shown up. Look at the people around you where He is showing up. Look in the Bible at all of God's promises and hold on to the faith that that's going to be true for you as well. That's my motivation for today. So shift your focus from what you don't have to what you do have. Whatever you're complaining about, make sure you've prayed about it more than you've complained about, or make sure you've prayed about it more than you've complained about it, and make sure you're taking it to the right source. Make sure you're taking it to God. All right, y'all, have a great day. See you next time.